It's Opie Aboard. Thanks for checking out the program tonight. And we got another fine show planned for you guys tonight.
Mm-hmm.
We got my pals Joe and Anthony from Rotgut live in the studio.
Opie! How you doing, man?
Good, man. Just in case people don't know who you are yet.
Yeah, well, all that
they are the famous authors of Gun Electric Shock OJ, which mm-hmm. you're going to do live on the show tonight.
That's right.
And you're going to do other ditties.
Yeah, other wacky, kooky stuff, Obi. You know?
We're a little bitter. We gave Eddie Vedder the idea to do that.
Yeah, there you go. That's what someone just said. You know, they heard Pearl Jam's version of Sitting on the Dock of the Bay, and they were expecting to hear the OJ version.
sounded like he was heavily sedated.
Right.
Yeah.
All right, I need a ruling. I started a new bit yesterday, Celebrity Death Watch.
Right, yep.
All right, you might have heard this last night. Monday, Jessica Tandy, the old broad from Driving Miss Daisy, died.
Hey, I'll take that contract. How old was she?
85.
Oh, please.
Anyways, I don't know about you, but I've always been under the celebrities die in threes, basically.
Always,
right? So it's the Celebrity Death Watch. I guarantee two more prominent celebrities will die before October 1st. So we're just waiting and watching. George Burns in the hospital the other day.
It was a close call. Very close call.
But he got out of it. Yeah. 98 years old. He has, like, his brain is swelling.
He pulled out.
And he pulled out of it. I was like, darn.
I always wanted to see George Burns singing that extreme song. If you don't like what you see here, get the funk out. But he never does that.
Very good.
Maybe now, after he's bopped on the head.
But I need a ruling. I got an obituary. Patrick O'Neill, 66.
Mm.
People are going, Patrick who? Now, I said it has to be a prominent celebrity. This guy was in Stepford Wives, 1975.
Ooh.
What do you think? It's on the fence. Is he prominent?
Let me see, Joe. What do you think?
I rule nay.
No. All right. So it's still one with two celebrities to go 2 weeks from now.
Two to go.
All right. Well, we're going to debut real fast a song from Rotgut about the Cuban refugees.
Right. There was a Billy Joel made a tribute to the Baymen.
Right.
And we figured, you know, why not go to the other southern half of the states and make a little tribute to the Cuban boat people.
Let's check it out on the Nighttime Attitude. Gotta love that. Rotgut on the Nighttime Attitude. It's Opie in the Nighttime Attitude. Squeeze, of course, and Tempted. Sending that out to Sally in Levittown, faithful listener of the program.
My choice, Op.
I'm out of my mind tonight because I got Joe and Anthony from Rotgut, and these guys are you guys are mental.
That's right.
But thanks for stopping on by. I appreciate it.
No problem.
Anytime.
We're glad to do it. Pizza Deluso, Comac.
Oh, jeez. No.
That would be Cliff. Yeah, no, that would be Cliff, Joe, and Greg. Joe. All we have to do is say it 10 times and we get
this
a free pizza.
Are you serious?
They deliver it. They're going to deliver it right here.
All right, do it real fast.
Right, guys. That would be Pizza Deluso, Pizza Deluso, Pizza Deluso, Pizza Deluso, Pizza Deluso. That's 5, 6. Pizza Deluso, 7.
I said it too.
Pizza Deluso. Oh, so that's 10.
We're up to 12. That's a point and a half.
All right, all right. Cliff, get in your van and start down here. I want one with everything on it.
Great.
Thank you.
My boss is going to love that one. That was about $1,000 worth of advertising.
Yeah.
Thanks, guys. I appreciate it. All right. Hey, we have Sam Kinison in the studio tonight, too.
Sam. Hey, old man. How you doing, bud?
Pretty good.
Yeah, we're hanging out with the guys tonight, having a good time.
From Rotgut?
Yeah, I'm hoping that pizza comes down. I'm losing a little weight being dead.
Hey, Sam, what do you think of O.J. Simpson?
Oh, guilty as sin. I was talking to Nicole and her waiter friend. Yeah, she said he came up, looked pretty angry, stuck a knife in her, you know, the whole deal.
Okay. Very good. Speaking of which, I think it's time to do Gonna Electric Shock O.J. live on the Nighttime Attitude. It's Rotgut. Check this out.
Sitting in Los Angeles jail, and that judge won't let me post my bail. Now this could be the end of me, 'cause California's got that death penalty. They gone electric shock OJ, cook my behind like a chicken croquet. They gone electric shock, OJ, toast my behind. Nicole, I really loved that girl, but she had the worst luck in the world. I was only cleaning my knife, I accidentally stabbed her 36 times. They gone electric shock, OJ, cook my behind like a cherry flambé. Ooh, they gone electric shock, OJ, toast my behind. Looks like I'm a guilty man. Love lots of women, now I'm gonna have to love my hands. But what's worse, what make me flip my lid, I hear Michael Jackson is watching my kids. Why don't they cut me some slack? I'm an athlete, movie star, and I'm black. While lawyers argue over my hair, they be warming up that electrical chair. Ooh, they gone electric shock, OJ, look my behind like a flounder fillet. Ooh, they gone electric shock, OJ, roast my behind.
Give me a call.
Get me the hell out of here.
I was in Chicago. I swear I wasn't even
near
the girl.
Big gone electric shock, OJ.
Boy, I do that whistle better than any better.
Bravo.
Hey, Joe, I think you did whistle better than any better.
We're hanging out with Rotgut on the Nighttime Attitude. They got a song about the guy that crashed into the White House.
Oh, that kook.
That we're going to debut in a few that you're going to love. Yo, B.A.B.
Hey, kiddo. How you doing?
Mickey J.
Yeah, what's happening?
The mayor of Montauk. How are you, bro?
What do you think about the O.J. now, man? The DNA came in and said his blood is true.
His blood is true?
Yeah, his blood.
What do you mean his blood is true?
Well, they said with the DNA,
right?
They said It's his blood that was on the path of his house there. You better find some good drugs, OJ. Don't pull yourself, boys, going up your poop tube.
Wait, what was that line again?
Don't fool yourself, boys, going up your poop tube. Hey, tell Rocco, send me a piece of pizza when he comes out this weekend.
Who's Rocco?
Your buddy's there, right? They ordered a pizza.
Hey, it's Rocco's pizza.
Well, that would be Rotgut, but close enough, bro. You want to sing a song tonight, buddy? Well, how about a little Zeppelin? Rocco wants to play while you sing.
Okay, go, man, go.
All right, which one do you want to sing? Good times, bad times?
Yeah, there you go.
All right, whenever you're ready, bro.
Okay, go, man, go. In my days of my youth, I was told what it means to be a man. Now, five times now, you know I've had my share. When a woman comes around again, I don't seem to care. Boo, 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 boo!
Ladies and gentlemen, Mickey J!
I should start talking like a DJ, man.
Jethro Tull, it's Opie in the Nighttime Attitude. Just want to remind you quickly, tomorrow is Friday, and we're still looking for your suggestions for the perfect lunch hour. And in the studio live tonight, I mean, they've been doing so much cool stuff for my show, I thought I owed it to them to bring them in live. It's Rotgut.
Thank you very much.
We got a... someone called in before and requested a reggae song. We don't know many.
All right.
We know one reggae song. It's a pale reggae song. Well, very pale. Give it a whirl.
Let's check it out.
It's a story of a lovely lady who was bringing up three very lovely girls, and they were such lovely girls. All of them had hair of black, and just like their mamas. The youngest one in dreadlocks. It's a story of a man named Brady, who was busy with three boys of his own. Three boys, very busy, three boys. They were four men living all together.
Rasta men,
yeah.
Jamaica.
And they all get stoned. The Brady Blunts.
Rastafari in the Brady.
The Brady Blunts.
Rastafari in the Brady Blunts.
That's the way we became the Brady Blunts.
Bravo. That's beautiful. Hey, if you got something to add to the program tonight, 955 WBAB. By the way, I got a surprise. We're going to end this show in style tonight. That's all I can say because someone else just called up.
Let the cat out of the bag.
Can I give you a hint?
Right, let the cat out of the bag.
All right, give a hint.
Ooh.
All right, that's good. That's a very good hint, by the way. Quickly, what do you guys think about the guy who flew his plane into the White House? Was this guy thinking or what, huh?
I think the voice recorder came on and went, am I, like, cleared for landing or something?
And I mention that because I'm, like, the king of segs. Rotgut got, they have a new song about the kook that flew his plane into the White House, and we're going to debut that right now on the Nighttime Attitude. Check it out.
He flew through the air with a mental disease, his head up his ass, he'd bark when he sneezed. Visit Bill and Hillary, but the White House, it got in his way. Well, he heard about some guy in Russia that landed his plane in Red Square. He said, I'll outfly that commie bastard. Then a propeller parted his hair. He fell from the air with the grace of a flea, his neck in the cockpit, his head in the trees. That dumb motherfucker must have had it for brains. Who the fuck let him pilot that plane?
You guys could be more demented than myself, I think. Yo, B.A.B.
Hey, Opie, how you doing? It's
Debo. Faithful listener to the program, Debo. Tell all the faithful listeners out there how big your breasts got last night.
Opie, they kept growing.
They grew after you left here?
Yeah.
You're lying.
No, I don't really remember what they were, but I think they grew like 2 inches.
Are you serious?
Yeah. 34 and a half was the top.
Right.
35.
Right.
And 32.
So you got a ways to go still, but that's a start, right?
Yeah.
So did you like the hypnotist that made breasts larger through hypnosis last night?
I loved it.
People thought I was full of you-know-what, but it worked, right?
It sure did.
All right, what do you got tonight, baby?
I wrote a poem about it.
Let's hear it.
Sure was witty of me to increase my boobs on WBAD. A stretching feeling and a tingle. Now I'm ready to go out and mingle. One guy reached out and copped a feel. I turned and said, yeah, baby, they are real. I want to say thanks to Opie and Mike, because now my boobs, the guys seem to like.
All right, yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, Debo.
Yeah.
And her new and improved boobit.
I like it. I hope they last long.
Who feels worse than me? My record company. Jobs went down the drain when I blew out my brains. Depression didn't kill me. It was MTV. Why they have to play Snoop Doggy Dog all day. I took a gun, I couldn't take it anymore. I took a gun, shoot me, shoot me.
One more verse.
I got that part.
There's my brain, it's on the wall. There's my brain, it's on the wall. There's my brain, it's on the wall. There's my brain, it's on the wall.
Long Island's best rock, WBAB, Nirvana. And if you haven't figured it out yet, I got my buddies Rod Gut in the studio, Joe and Anthony. Man, right after Kurt Cobain killed himself, I started abusing, you know, the whole thing right away. I had to literally hide for a month. Everyone got pissed at me.
We actually did it that night at New York Avenue down in Huntington.
Right.
We did the parody that you just heard. That night. The night of the news of Kurt Cobain.
We did that song complete with gunfire.
It was a mess.
Tasteless.
It was brutal. Yeah. People wanted me bad. I had to hide. But we started the abuse when he slipped into the coma in Rome.
Oh, yeah.
We came up with one. Drugs! Booze! I'm in a coma now! Drugs! Booze! I'm in a coma now. So we were on top of that from the beginning, man. This is a lot of fun. I hope it sounds good on the radio, because we're breaking all sorts of rules to have you guys here. I hope you appreciate that.
Yeah, oh, believe me.
What do you guys think of
the... By the way, let me just say, Pizza Deluso showed up in the pizza.
I know. I got off the phone with my boss. He's not happy about that, but that's okay. Free pizza, what the hell. What do you guys think of the whole Haiti thing?
Ah, the Haiti thing.
Wrote a little song about it, like to play it for you now. Here, go.
Oh, what a coincidence. All right, let's hear a little bit of that.
Now, this is on the way to here.
No. This was actually out in the lobby. We just prepared it.
You just came up with this in the lobby?
Yeah.
Wait, quickly, before you go into this, I got a little commentary. I think it's unbelievable that, like, the cameraman and the news people are just waiting for the invasion to happen. I mean, these guys are trying to sneak in, and, oh, here they come, and they're going to have all the spotlights and the camera lights.
Smile, G.I.
Smile, you're on CNN, everybody. Whatever happened to, like, sneak attacks?
We took off candid cameras and hid them in the bunker.
Watch as Fannie Flagg plays the unsuspecting nation as we put all candid cameras.
Alan Blunt.
and in the paper today, they got your, like, your program for the invasion.
Oh, yeah.
All the diagrams and
times
stuff.
Times everything.
I've got my seat in the mezzanine.
All right.
Thank you.
Well, let's hear a quick song.
Saddam Hussein, he had his scuds. They got voodoo dolls and chicken blood. We're going to Haiti. Haiti. Haiti's the pits. Yeah. Devag is the one. Devag is the one. Devag is the one. Haiti. Haiti. Yeah, we're gonna kick that general out. Woo!
More from Rot Gut and great rock and roll as well, and whatever you want to add to the program.
Yeah, hi, I'm just calling to tell you that I think that parody about Kurt Cobain was disgusting and should not have been played on the radio.
Okay, we respect your opinion, sir.
Okay, and, like, I really hope that if, like, Opie ever kills himself, I'm just going to laugh my ass off about it.
Okay, I'll tell Opie.
Okay, thanks a lot.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Yo, B.A.B.
Yo, Opie, what's up? This is Barry.
Barry,
what's
Barry, are you enjoying the show tonight?
Oh, of course I am.
What made you laugh?
Oh, every freaking skit that you did tonight. Hey,
wow.
I love your show. I listen to it every time I get a chance to.
All right, I love your show, too. What do you do?
Listen, I'm getting married in 2 days.
All right.
I want you to do something special, like punch out my wife or something over the radio.
What?
Yeah, what the hell?
It's good to know that romance is alive and well
in
the 90s.
You like the beating every once in a while.
Dude, don't you realize after the whole OJ thing, it's not really, like, cool to talk about punching out your wife?
Oh, but that's all right. I won't stab, but that's why I want you to do it. This way you get in trouble, not me.
All right, where's your wife? I got to talk to her.
All right, hold on.
All right.
Hello?
Hey, hello? Dawn.
Yes.
So you're going to marry this clown?
I sure am. I've never been happier.
You know he wants me to punch you out? Sweetie, I say we punch him in the face. What do you think?
Well, I'll take care of that later.
Well, check this out. And would you like to punch him in the groin as well?
No, I don't think punching is what I want to do.
All right, we'll kick him in the groin. Check this out. And how about we break his nose?
He's got to look up for the pitches.
Well, good luck with marriage. I think you guys might need it.
Thank you.
It's Opie and the Nighttime Attitude. We're going to open up the B.A.B. box office next. And live in the studio, if you're just tuning in, we brought in Rot Gut.
He's still here. We're not leaving.
And you might know him from Gun Electric Shock O.J., which they performed live on the show earlier. It was absolutely fine. And quickly, I got to explain something. Rot Gut helped me out with a ruling. I got a new bit on this program called the Celebrity Death Watch.
Yeah.
Because if you're like me, you have noticed that celebrities die in threes.
Always. I bet the farm on George Burns.
He keeps coming back, man. He had brain swelling on Tuesday. He's 98, fell in his bathtub.
My brain is swelling.
And supposedly he's going to be all right. That's
of course.
Scary.
Of course.
So let's go over this real fast. Jessica Tandy died Monday. She's one.
Right.
And I predict within the next 2 weeks, two more prominent celebrities will, you know, keel right. over. And we just got a ruling that Patrick O'Neill, he was in Stepford Wives,
right.
which is a sick movie, but he wasn't prominent
Didn't
enough.
Didn't do much after
so
that.
So still, it's only one celebrity has
That's
died.
It.
So we're still looking for two more. Any suggestions, yeah. possibly?
We were thinking before, Ray Combs, the old host of Family Feud.
The one,
now old host.
Right.
Because Richard Dawson
was
the host.
Okay.
Then they had Ray Combs. He had a horrible accident.
Right.
And now he's been in some kind of near-death coma
for months.
A long time. Almost a year.
So he would definitely
So count. They brought back Richard Dawson for the beard.
Have you seen him?
He's the most bloated,
right.
graying. He looks horrendous.
Come over here, honey. Suck my face.
Let's give Richard a little kiss.
Know who he reminds me of?
Oh.
Dudley Moore, all the way.
Where the hell's my hat? Hi, Linda. Excuse me, that. Oh, your head. He's taking the knife out of the cheese. You think he wants some cheese?
All right. Very good. You guys ready to perform another song?
Oh, sure.
Yeah. Oh, wait a minute. Very special dedication to Randy and Dave. Playing poker tonight.
I had to say that.
All right. Very
good. No, I didn't have to. I love those guys.
Watch Randy. He's cheating.
Okay.
Oh. It's the Elvis medley because of Lisa Marie and yes. Michael Jackson.
Since my daughter's wedding, my crying just won't stop. I was dead and resting peaceful. Now I'm spinning like a top, baby. My daughter's married to
My daughter's married to my daughter married a pedophile. The wedding was a big joke. The honeymoon was crap. How could he be romantic holding Webster on his lap, baby? My daughter's married to my daughter's married to my daughter married a pedophile. My daughter got married to the king of pop. Was spinning in my grave and I just can't stop. Praying to God they don't have no kids with a brain like hers and a face like his. I'm in shock. The king is in shock. Lisa married the king of pop. Well, the whole thing is a crock. Look at Michael Jackson watching TV. The hungry little boy sitting on his knee. Offers him a snack and gets off his rocks. He sticks it through the bottom of the popcorn box. I'm in shock. The king is in shock. Lisa married the king of pop. Well, the whole thing is a crock. She's a fool. My little girl's a fool. She's a fool. My little girl's a fool. On her wedding day, I wish she would have married O.J.
This is Fred, drummer from Rock God. I need a ruling on
Hey, Fred. You need a ruling on who?
Your celebrity dying in threes over there?
Yeah, Celebrity Death Watch. We got Jessica Tandy. We're waiting for two more to die in the next 2 weeks. Who do you think?
How about R. Carney?
He's not dead, Fred. He looks dead, but officially he's still alive. He's in that Abe Vigoda category. He looks dead. People think he's dead, but he's still breathing.
The Nighttime Attitude. It's Ope. Hope you're enjoying the program. We're having an absolute riot tonight.
Yeah. How you doing, man?
Sam Kinison back
here. Yeah, we're stopping back over here. Just, like, bloated myself on some pie. You got those people in here going to be spanking each other?
Yeah. Here, give me a little whipping post so I can explain this. I actually had a guy just call up. He's coming by with his wife.
Do you call that a wife?
And he wants to spank her live on the air tonight.
Yeah, who doesn't?
And the hotline's ringing. That's my boss. We're not going to answer that. Boss, I'll be good. And he has, like, hot wax he wants to do tonight on the program.
Yeah.
So, I don't know. Possibly that will happen.
Yeah, maybe he'll bring him in.
He drops it on her mammalian protuberances.
So we got Rod Good in the studio. We're discussing freaking everything. What do you guys think about Marion Barry?
Whoa! I heard your earlier thing. I liked the top five.
The top five Marion Barry.
He'll take a crack at it.
Right. Yeah. He'll be taking a crack at it this coming election. Very good. He's going to be the mayor of Washington again.
I think he'd be elected. Yeah,
he went to jail for smoking crack. Hello! Too bad
it doesn't matter anymore.
Too bad that this show is not in Washington. Hey, people!
Wake up,
dude. PC. Your mayor was smoking crack. All right?
Boy, that's okay with me.
He smoked.
As the Washington Monument stands like a giant hypodermic needle, I will govern.
Right.
I will govern.
Unbelievable.
His name is Marion.
And, of course, the big news a little while ago was the Cuban refugees. Now we might have Haitian refugees. Oh, boy. Happy, happy, joy, joy.
Happy, happy, joy, joy.
So you guys came up with another Cuban refugee song.
Yes, another one.
This one's hysterical.
This one is just in case. This one is just in case they start coming over again, in case the deal falls through.
All right.
And
we do have a disclaimer on this song.
Yes.
Right, our guitarist, Rex, he is actually Cuban, so we can't even get in trouble for this.
All right. Let's check it out on the Nighttime Attitude. We're coming back with the all-request and dedication hour. We might invite this couple in. I don't know.
That almost sounded like Mr. Howell. The all-request.
Check out the tune, man.
Drown, drown, Cuban, drown, drown, Cuban, drown. Yeah, Cuban, drown, 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 Cuban, drown. Refugees, give them a hand. Roll for days just to open up a taco stand. 20 Cubans float on a wine bottle cork. Guantanamo Bay is just a 5-minute walk. Turn around. Cuban drown, drown, Cuban drown, yeah. Cuban drown, drown, drown.
I can see the complaint calls and the complaint letters a mile away, ladies and gentlemen. Got Rutgut in the studio.
Ooh,
a little Ozzy.
Yeah, yeah, it's the Ozzy Lounge Act.
Don't be.
Yeah. That's right, everybody, sing along here in the Catskills. Yeah, I'm crazy. So are you. That's how it goes. Come on, everybody.
Millions of people.
Millions, Joe.
They
take them right off.
Hey, nothing's to worry
hey,
about.
Hey, I'm crazy. And you know I am. That's how it goes.
Millions of people.
Try the veal here all week. Thank you, thank you. We'll be here all week.
Okay, good. Opie in the nighttime attitude. We have Rotgut live in the studio.
Yeah.
And just when you thought the show couldn't get any more interesting.
Let's get ready to rumble!
Oh, boy. If you've been listening to the program tonight, we have this S&M couple that has been begging to be on the show for the last few weeks. Master Spike.
I think she's been begging.
Master Spike. Give Master Spike a microphone. Grab that mic, sir.
How
are
you doing?
You are a scary mo-ho.
No, it's all right. Because you're so small.
Yes, I'm tiny compared to you. Yes. Now that's your wife, right? That's dressed in the leather.
That's my
get-up.
Wife. Slant slave.
Can she bend over so we can see the brand on her?
On a brand?
Oh,
sure.
A brand.
You actually branded your wife.
Take this right off.
Oh, oh my God! Look at that butt.
I
want to see the brand.
Now, don't lose your footing.
Don't lose your footing.
Yeah. All right, very good. That's a couple of couple quick spanks.
Yes, let's warm it up.
And you brought all sorts of sex toys. Let's hear the whip.
Sex toys. They're gear. Discipline toys.
Discipline. Called them artillery before. I
heavy artillery.
I want to hear the whip real fast.
Oh, the whip? Sure.
Everyone, move back. Hold. Move over. Duck. Oh, my God.
That's frightening.
Right. I've seen some towel snapping in the locker room, but this is way out of hand.
Do we have security in the building? Okay, so this is all in fun. I got to say this away because...
this is just to have fun.
So you do bachelor parties, right?
Mm-hmm.
And
yep.
You did one tonight, and Master Spike's not happy with you.
No, I'm very, very disappointed about
that. He said I was...
a dirty little slut.
Oh. Oh. I don't think you can say
okay.
That.
I'll be here all week. Try the veal. Thank you very much.
No.
All right, wait. Before you discipline her, we're going to play a little whipping post music, I think.
Oh, yes.
Oh, yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
All right. So explain what she did, Mistress
Blake. Well, we went to this bachelor party tonight, and unfortunately, she went over there, and she was standing... with all her beauty.
I was flashing this older gentleman.
Okay.
And he got really excited, and everyone thought he was going to have a heart attack.
Not to mention she was stark bird naked.
Naked? Okay.
Naked.
So what's going to happen now?
Well, she has to get disciplined because she was taking her flappers right over the guy as he was laying down.
All right.
And she was wiggling her torso.
Okay, listen. We got a nice spanking chair for you.
Oh, this chair is
just perfect.
Armless and warmed up.
Yes.
All right. By the way, this lady is beautiful, man.
Very absolutely. Attractive.
Blonde what hair, perfect here? Body, oh, and a leather getup, tattoos.
Oh,
hello.
Oh, boy.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Wait a minute. Does that hurt?
Spike is using the southpaw stance.
And you like this?
Oh.
Yes, she does.
Oh, it's hot.
Does that turn you on, really?
It's like... extended foreplay.
Sure.
All right.
Why don't you let Opie pour some hot wax on my...
Yeah, all right. Come here, Opie. Come on over here.
Wait. Let me play a couple commercials. Right after the commercials, I will do that. I will do that. Stay right there. All right. Enough with the whip already. All right. Wait.
Okay. So quickly, we got to do this because we got to get back into songs. So what are we doing? Tripping some wax now?
Yeah, we're going to put some hot wax on.
All right.
He's going to put some hot wax.
This is how demented the show got tonight. The guy that delivered the pizza about 3 hours ago is still hanging out. I don't even know this guy, but now I do.
Ooh.
She's bent over.
The pizza guy.
Her lovely round ass is right in front of me.
Help me with my ultimate fantasy.
You really want me to drip this wax on you?
Wait, what's the ultimate fantasy?
All right, here we go. Here we go. It's perfect. Purple wax. Here it is.
Uh-oh. Here it comes.
Very nice.
Oh.
Try and make an X, Opie.
That doesn't hurt.
Ooh.
Ooh, feels
it's
good.
Hot.
I just,
that's hot.
I just dripped my initials in her butt.
Yeah, it's Opie. Look at that. Right.
Sorry, my handwriting is pretty sloppy, but there you go. All right. I want to thank Master Spike and his slave for stopping on by the Nighttime Attitude, where you never know who's going to... Enough with the whip already, all right? We're just about wrapping up the Nighttime Attitude. We got a lot of people to thank tonight. I want to thank TJ and Bobby for producing the show tonight. I want to thank Mickey J from Montauk and his mission of Good Times, Bad Times. We want to thank all the people, all the pizza off the radio after we abused Kurt Cobain. They were part of the show. Thank you. Who else we want to thank? Oh, the pizza dude.
The pizza
who decided to stay for 3-4 hours.
He's driving right now going, that's
and
me.
Cliff.
that's me.
We want to thank Master Spike and his slave.
Oh.
If you're just tuning in the radio, it's going to take way too long to explain. Boy. Unbelievable.
Never be able to explain it.
Want to thank Nikki G for stopping by. Who else?
Just make the album.
Oh, you guys. Oh, yeah.
I felt so at home here. I had to thank somebody.
Rotgut.
Want to thank Rotgut. Where are you guys going to be next?
We're going to be on the 23rd, we're doing a show at Hofstra at the USA. That's the on-campus club.
All right.
Over at Hofstra University. In
University.
In Hofstra University.